The most critical piece is making sure everybody's happy with it. So it's not just me as the architect and the professional, but also my husband and my daughter need to be happy with the house. And so making sure that it fits everyone's needs is a really critical piece as well.
We're at a hillside home in LA that has a recent addition built using passive house standards. And we found out pretty quickly that these views are just the beginning of something great.
I'm Sylvia, and I'd like to welcome you to my passive house that we're just finishing in Northeast Los Angeles. Energy efficiency had always been part of my upbringing. I was inspired by passive house and used that strategy to make the house more not only energy efficient, but actually more comfortable. And in the end, that's been the bigger benefit to us. You know, energy conservation and saving money is wonderful, but to actually enjoy a comfortable space is, you know, something meaningful every minute. I'm, of course, the architect. I'm also the passive house consultant on the project. And I had a general contractor for the shell portion of the house. But once we got the shell completed, I was really acting more or less as the general contractor, hiring all the subs directly. So that's been far more time intensive than I would have preferred. It's been a labor of love for sure. So this part of the house is fiber cement siding. The old house is redwood siding. Tilt turn windows, we used windows from Germany. They're double pane because of our nice climate, but very well insulated frames and very airtight. These windows were carefully planned with the mountains in mind, you know, because we got the snowy mountains out of the big window. And then there are a couple other mountains out of the little window. We have a very high efficiency electric heat pump with a pretty standard air handler and ducted heating, air conditioning, and ventilation. We also have the ventilation is a separate system that has heat recovery. And that's a key component of a passive house. Very key to its passive house performance is the air tightness. So the envelop of the building has been sealed primarily with taped plywood. There's also a variety of other products used. So we designed the addition to be lower than the existing house so we could maintain our view. So we also had this roof sloped to face the south for PV. We have a photovoltaic panel system to generate electricity, which is, you can see behind me. We have three rain barrels on site, so yeah, these are 450 gallon. So this really only captures half of the roof area. Some of my drains are just going out into the garden, so only half are going into there. And it only captures, I think it was a 1-inch storm. So I'm gonna have to empty them out before the next storm. The quiet is something that we didn't design for. We didn't really spend money particularly to achieve the quiet, but it's just a wonderful benefit of having a well-insulated house that has high-performing windows. It's wonderful to be able to count on having high air quality, nice filtered air inside the house. Of course, we love to open our windows and we open them whenever we can, but if there is a wildfire, or even if the neighbor is using their wood-burning fire stove, we can close the windows and breathe easily. What's been really wonderful to watch is the industry develop and see more and more products available that you can use to help improve the performance of your house. It's just a pleasure to see things become readily available and to find contractors who actually know how to use the products. A key to making it work properly in the end is to think thoroughly about the commissioning aspect, to make sure that your contractor is going to be able to follow through to make sure that all the systems are working well together. You don't want each individual component to be working and not speaking to the other piece that it should be speaking to. You may need to pay a little bit more just to get the right contractor, and that's worth it. You're going to be happier in the end. Experience that I've had in the residential side on my own house is actually had a really big impact on my work as an architect in the non-residential side. It was really because of this initial foray into passive house for my own house that I was able to really push into much more ambitious projects beyond. I am an architect and it's ended up pushing my whole career much more deeply into sustainability and mitigation of climate change.
Thanks so much for tuning in, guys. For more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the button below. And also check out buildwithrise.com, the only place to turn any home improvement project into a sustainable one.